So good afternoon. This presentation, like said, will be about the beauty, the structural quality and sustainability of tensile surface structures. If we look to conventional structures, they can carry a load which is a fraction of their self-weight. While tensile surface structures can carry a load much higher than their self-weight, and hence they are structurally efficient. The first step in the design of tensile surface structures is a form finding, finding at the same time the geometry and the internal forces in the equilibrium shape. Physical modeling is still a good way to explore equilibrium shapes, be it with soap films or with stretchable fabric. It is also a good strategy to incorporate a supporting structure in these physical explorations. The supporting structure transfers the pre-stress and the actions on the membrane to the foundations using poles, tie-down cables, beams, or arches, making integrated physical as well as integrated numerical models gives a better insight in the structural behavior. Flexible structures require a non-linear analysis model, making good estimations for wind and snow load on these doubly curved shapes is not always easy. So far, the introduction on tensile surface structures. The first theme I want to illustrate is that tensile surface structures can be beautiful buildings. It is not obvious to formulate criteria for beauty, but creativity could contribute. Respecting the historical elements on site, be inspired by nature, trying to build lightweight, softness could have an effect, acoustic comfort could influence the appreciation of a building, as well as being adaptable, removable, reusable. The first element is creativity. The edge of this shade structure is a cable connected to the boundary of the membrane by transverse cable segments. It gives the impression that the membrane is oscillating above the walkway. Isidro Ferrer did write a poem of Graça Toro on the canopy. You can read the poem on the canopy, as well as on the ground. In the spirit of sustainability, it really is a pity that this canopy was only used once. Another aspect is to give value to the historic elements. The medieval Curragh Castle in the Aish Valley became a new cultural space. Visually, there is a playful contrast between the massiveness of the ancient masonry and the lightness of the membrane with its natural fluid form. The canopy is almost floating. The membrane is not at all overwhelming. It is just there where it has to be. Another element is nature, being inspired by or even using nature. The open-air theater, Wilgenborg, is a construction of living willow branches, supported by a steel structure. After some time, the willows will become dominant over the steel structure. To be able to use the willows as supporting structure, it is important that the willows are guided correctly along the steel structure. And it is assumed that after 4 years, it would be possible to install a tensile roof in the Willow Cathedral. In the meantime, events still take place in open air. The next element is weight. This bubble is in fact rather a cuboid. The self-weight of this structure is not much more than the weight of the skin. The visitors are literally sucked into the interior and enter through vertical slit-like openings. The interior is a forest of ropes that divide the space into cells. Each one of the tensors can be regulated to alter the height of a cell. This pleasant effect encourages to play with a shape. Internal pressure and the flexibility of the skin allow for shape adjustments. And even artistic performances inside and outside. The next aspect is softness. The building of the Textile Academy in Mönchengladbach has a pre-stressed cable membrane facade. Cables and membrane are mounted on horizontal steel arches. The structure's architecture projects the academy's teaching program beyond its walls, providing a public showcase for the many and varied uses of textiles. Slightly transparent and suggestive of movement, this skin comes in stark contrast to the geometry of the cube behind. The lighting in the evening creates a fairy tale look. And in wintertime, the facade is like a white veil. Also, acoustic comfort is important to value a building. The Orium is a Scotland's sport performance center in Edinburgh. The football pitch roof uses an asymmetric arch profile with a high rise-to-span ratio and considerable curvature, forming an efficient structure with a comparatively low overall weight. The internal environment has been designed and tested to ensure acoustic comfort and speech intelligibility throughout the building. Tensioned PVC-coated polyester fabric was chosen to clad the football pitch roof, as it offered sufficient light transmission to limit the need for artificial lighting while managing heat gain. 2D arches create the overall shape, and smaller diagonal arches create the curvature in the skin. A no longer used historic garden enclosed by a fine red brick wall is preserved in the design and contrasts with the modern facility. Adaptability could make a building more attractive, creating a cover when needed and allowing an open air event in case of fine weather. This cover in Tecklenburg was built in 1992 and has been refurbished in 2016. When the retractable roof is extended, the membranes are inflated into cushions to make them more wind resistant. The supporting structure was reused, the old membrane was replaced. The opening and closing of the roof was accelerated by installing more powerful suction and pressure blowers. The cushions are attached to movable transversal beams. And these movable beams are supported by cable trusses. On the 27th and 28th of this month, the Summer Gala 21 will take place with a live concert. Typically, membrane canopies are removable, which is especially important for archaeological sites. Two large shelters have been designed for the Hagarkin and Mnashra temples in Malta. The philosophy behind these protective shelters was to immediately and significantly retard the main external causes of deterioration. A membrane shelter is low risk, quickly installed, and reversible. Tourists appreciate to visit these sites independent of the weather conditions. A reusable structural system can support beauty. A cover for two paddle fields was created at the ADEPS Center in Jambes. The structure is a triangulated grid for both the roof and the facades. Overhanging struts are held in position by tie-down cables and the membrane roof. Floating masts create the curvature in the roof. The supporting triangulated grid is covered with a tension membrane roof, but for the facades, they can open and close with flat membrane panels. Here too, paddle fields are covered, but other configurations are possible. The roof allows people to enjoy playing paddle, covered, but still with the impression of being outside. The next theme is the structural quality of tensile surface structures. A good membrane structure not only requires a well thought out construction, it is also important that standards are met. In 2010, CENTI-C 250, responsible for the Eurocode parts, formed Working Group 5 to elaborate a specific part on membrane structures. It is the aim that with commonly agreed standards and harmonized safety levels, the quality of membrane structures will improve. In the Eurocode, structural safety is based on a probabilistic approach. We identify limit states, evaluate the risks, and design in such a way that the probability of these risks remain low. We adopt representative values for actions and resistances, apply partial safety factors to actions and resistances, and introduce safety margins for the models of actions and action effects. We verify ultimate limit states, which means that the design value for the resistance has to be larger than the corresponding effect. And for the serviceability limit states, it means that the limiting design value for the serviceability criterion has to be larger than the corresponding effect. Combinations of actions have to be verified, and recommended values for the partial safety factors have to be used. The partial safety factors are a function of the target reliability index beta. Working Group 5 has meanwhile prepared the technical specifications TS 19102. The harmonization with respect to the Eurocode parts for other materials assures consistency, and this allows also to use integrated models for the design. Modification factors K are used to consider separate effects, for instance, load duration, environmental effects, biaxial or temperature effects, influencing the membrane properties in specific design situations. So the table shows typical design conditions and the modification factors that should be used for these specific design conditions. For instance, line one, in case of pre-stress, the modification factors for biaxial effects, for aging, permanent duration of the load, temperature effects and size are used. While for wind, line 5, only the modification factors for biaxial effects, aging and size are used. We are still looking for additional data for material properties. We have to specify appropriate examples for the consequence classes and the execution classes, and to verify to what extent execution rules for foils and structural membranes influence the structural safety. The third theme I want to speak about is sustainability. In every design, we must try from the start to optimize the production, the use phase, and the end-of-life treatment of components and materials. The life expectancy of coated fabrics is between 20 and 40 years. For ETFE foils, more than 100 years. If not worn out, can membranes be reused? And if worn out, can membranes not be wasted? The shown temporary structure has been made from ribbons of coated fabric scrap material. This chart was discussed in the TensiNet working group, Sustainability and Comfort. I cannot read on my screen the different topics, but I will try. So for the sustainability of textile architecture, we should inform the clients. We should also introduce life cycle design. We should compare structures made from different materials. We should try to improve the laws in such a way that fabricators are obliged to be more sustainable. And the materials, we should also treat them in a more sustainable way, trying to reuse them and to recycle them. So, the crucial question is, what is a membrane building's environmental performance? This end-of-life situation does not look good at all. So, case studies have been analyzed to evaluate circularity in use and the current options for the end-of-life phase. The first three case studies have been made from PVC-coated polyester, and the fourth uses an ETFE cushion system. The first case study is Wolkemarienveld, next to Finn Mechanica Pavilion, Elster Grandstand and Vodafone project. So the Pope's stage roof, Wolkemarienveld, was a pneumatic structure built in 2005. The cloud contains an elliptic ring with an upper cushion and four lateral cushions. Four towers support the grid of the roof, built by main and secondary trusses. At the end of the event, after 1 week, the construction was dismantled. The modular towers and truss components from StageCo were transported to the warehouses to be reused. It is the philosophy of StageCo, supplying stages for international tours to build, dismantle and reuse structural elements. StageCo has since a long time several warehouses over Europe. On the other side, the membrane was thrown away, probably brought to landfill. The Finn Mechanica Pavilion was built for the International Air Show in 2006 in the UK. The kit of parts system was designed as light as possible while considering the most appropriate dimensions for easy assembly, disassembly, and reconfiguration. The pavilion has a lightweight pneumatic facade with a white inside and a translucent outside PVC foil. What you see on the next pictures. After 4 weeks, the construction was dismantled and stored. The pavilion was reused in 2008, in 2010, and in a different setup in 2013 in France. The steel frame could still be reused, but what happened with the membrane and with the foils is not known. Probably, again, landfill. The Elfse grandstand cover was built in 78, and the membrane was replaced in 2014. The open canopy is hanging on two main cables. The primary structure was reused without major modifications. It will support the new roof for another 40 years. The old membrane, after being used 37 years, was thrown away. At the Vodafone project in the UK, the ETFE cushions in the roof were installed in 2001 and have been replaced in 2020. The primary structure has been reused and the foils were carefully dismantled and safely packed for transport. Vector Foiltech takes back all old material to recycle it and purchases flexible pipes and valves made from recycled ETFE. If we now compare the case studies, we see a much higher self-weight for Wolke-Marien felt, which is due to the heavy but reusable supporting towers and trusses. The air-inflated cushions of the Vodafone project are lightweight, even with the aluminium frame included. The membrane of Elfse grandstand canopy was used for 30 years. For the Wolke-Marienveld, 2 weeks. The Finmeccanica pavilion, the membrane was used 4 times for 4 weeks. The ETFE foils of the Vodafone project were used for 20 years. The ETFE foils have been recycled, which is beneficial. But the fact that the membrane of Wolke-Marienveld was thrown away after a use of 1 week, this should not happen. The project using PVC-coated polyester fabrics have, for the skin, similar values for the global warming potential and the primary energy demand. The values for the Vodafone project are about 10 times higher, but they include the supporting aluminium frame. In fact, to be able to judge about different solutions, the environmental indicators should be calculated separately for the skin and for the supporting structure. The PVC-coated polyester fabric was in all cases landfilled or incinerated. While coated fabrics, even after they have been used for some time, they are still valuable. Can we be inspired by other sectors like fashion? Ellen MacArthur started a foundation with the mission, make fashion circular. Can we push concepts like make textile architecture circular? Processes like TextiLoop show that recycling is possible. If we think now about the remaining challenges, considering climate change and looking for sustainable cities, membrane structures have the potential to provide solutions. As said before, if we produce materials, design and build, we must think from the start about the environmental performance of materials, components and buildings. Shouldn't the industry promote life cycle thinking, provide figures and transparent information, and discuss with clients to give premium for clean solutions? When I started my career some time ago, the Georgia Dome was considered as a masterpiece of engineering. I had never thought that one day, with a scheduled implosion, the whole roof should collapse to get rid of the building. Should we really turn into waste what still can be used or what can be recycled? We should take responsibility for the coming generations, recycle what is recyclable, and even if zero waste is probably not reachable soon. Can we, from now on, encourage cradle to cradle and especially promote valuable plastic to valuable plastic?